Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Trophinet, and welcome back to Bioshock in our Let's Replay series, where we try to delve a bit deeper into the story of this amazing game. We're still in Fontaine's apartment next to the taxidermist's polar bear. And we're not yet cured of our affliction, so we're randomly swapping through these plasmids. Right now we're using Incinerate Tree. And I think I kind of missed something here, apparently. Sad saps.
These sad saps. They come to Rapture thinking they're gonna be captains of industry. But they all forget that somebody's gotta scrub the toilets. What an angle they gave me. I hand these mugs a cot and a bowl of soup, and they give me their lives. Who needs an army when I got Fontaine's home for the poor?
And there we go, another look into how Fontaine managed to assemble that big of a rebel, well, kind of rebel army against Andrew Ryan. He just used a poorhouse he created. So now we're using Hypnotized Big Daddy, not really useful for what we're in right now. So let's try and loop around and hit that guy in the back. Thank you for that. Oh, that was three first aid kits.
Listen to me.
There we go. And now we swapped to Insect Swarm. Probably the most annoying thing about this is that you actually switch towards your plasmids even if you're not using them. So that might be an issue later on. But let's go back down and try to find the other lot 192 to cure us completely of our mental instability. Okay, and somebody triggered the camera apparently. Thank you. Before we leave the Mercury Suites here, I think these are the Mercury Suites, right? Yeah, I think they are. Let's go check out the last apartment that we haven't checked yet. Let's swap again towards telekinesis apparently. And that one is actually this one over here. The apartment of Anna Culpepper, the rival of Sander Cohen. There's a dead splicer over here already. Hello, sir. You looked better. And I hear a big daddy. I don't know how many we have left, actually. One. We still need to kill one big daddy. And there seems to be an audio diary right over there. So let's try this out. Artist woman. So, Sullivan, as you might remember from Fort Frolic, was ordered to kill Anna Culpepper, and he, according to this audio diary, he clearly did. And as you can see, the chameleon is doing its work as well. They don't really know I'm here now, do they? Look at that, it's always really, really funny. Oh, shit. La 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 la. There we go, that's one. And maybe act very stealthy towards the other one. And nope. Yes, I'm gonna touch you with my wrench. Nope, it's a dud. Okay, it's a dud. And since we're in her apartment, Sullivan stated that he killed her right here as well, which is actually really sad. But okay, we're gonna switch again to Winter Blast. Haven't really used Winter Blast yet. They might as well, right? Looks like there's a splicer right over there. There we go. Let's freeze the guy and whack him to bits. Because this, ladies and gentlemen, is Anna Culpepper, murdered in the bathtub. Let's search that. She has a bit of money on her. And that's the sad end of Anna Culpepper. I think, wasn't there another audio diary around here? I don't think... Can't seem to find one. Now it's decoy. I'm gonna be able to use that much. Well, not really aggressively, either way. I don't think there is, then. I thought there was another... audio diary around here about her death. But apparently there isn't, so let's head out. And then we're gonna have to go to Apollo Square to find Su Chong's lab, which should be interesting in its own right, of course. Because, Su Chong created the plasmids and, of course, was also responsible for our little mental breakdown. So we might learn a lot more over there. Thank you for the first aid kit, some coffee. And here we go again. Electrobolt. That's a bit more handy. Let's take that first aid kit. And now we're fully stocked again on first aid kits. Is there something else here? I don't think so. Aside from these lovely pictures indicating her work, her life and her work. Anna Culpepper's life. But, okay, let's leave. And next up is Apollo Square. Apollo Square, we heard a bit about it. Mainly because that's one of the places that was used to start the riots by Atlas's mob. So Fontaine's mob. And there we go again. Enrage, not really gonna use that. So let's just head outside. And I think the entrance to Apollo Square is back where we kind of started out, where we... Hi. Yeah, he sent me. Dude.
You'll be hanging from the...
Okay. And it kind of feels like every single grenade, every single death grenade of the Nitro Splices is now a dud, which is, of course, really handy. Not that I'm gonna suppose it's gonna always happen, but... I might as well, right? So I think we fully researched Rosie's. But we still have one little sister to take care of. Yeah, but I'm first gonna cure our plasmid swapping. So let's go to Apollo Square. So Apollo Square is its own little area, so I think... So we have two separate little sisters in this area. And as I said before, this is where most of the riots started out, and that's what this little gate is for. Looks like a frag grenade in between the cans, which is a bit weird. Seems like a broken down vending machine, which we can actually use. Funny. We don't need any of the hack-only stuff, so I'm just gonna buy... Wow. Don't really need to film, to be honest, because we only need to research the bouncer anymore. So please have Rapture ID cards ready before reaching checkpoints. Checkpoints were placed along the routes just to check if nobody related to Fontaine or Atlas should go through. So yeah, I might have prolonged that a bit so I got a better plasmid. But here's a really interesting audio diary of someone we really know by now.
I was so angry when I came down here, but my god, I had no idea. There's armed men all over the place. I saw a woman climb over the fence trying to escape. One of Ryan's guards pointed at her and she lit on fire. Just like that. What's happening here?
So Diane McClintock, last time we heard of her, so that's Andrew Ryan's wife, kinda. Last time we heard of her, she was so mad at the people that maimed her during New Year's Eve that she wanted to kill them. But now that she actually got here and saw what Andrew Ryan's, her husband's, men were doing to people that tried to get in, she changed her mind a bit. Because, of course, as we know, there was sort of an arms race going on regarding enhancing people. And I think that's not... Okay, it was a corpse, never mind. And, everybody was trying to create the better man, the stronger man.
Don't be a
Yeah, don't be a slowpoke, Mr. B. And I think I can go in here. Let's check out this guy. And let's swap again. Don't know what's going on, but apparently that splicer started to open fire on the Big Daddy. I don't think we need to help him. I think he can do that all on his own. Just gonna stay out of the way until I cured my my plasmids. No, nope, you're dead. You're completely and utterly dead. So, here we are at Apollo Square. Gene Traitor. Let's use the... oh, for fuck's sake. Let's use the crossbow to take out this guy. There we go. And he exploded. Seems to be one over there as well. Let's wait for him to come around the corner, maybe. Where did he go? There did he go. No, 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 no. There we go. Thanks for that. So that's where we came from. So, Gene, no, that's where we came from. Olympus Heights. Gene Traitors, I think we can pick up a few of the bolts here. And well, they started to hang people. I think we already knew that from one of the audio diaries, that traitors were getting hung by Andrew Ryan's men. People that affiliated themselves with Fontaine or Atlas were eventually hung for their punishment. Let's gather a bit of the bolts. And well, another bleak sight in Rapture, indicating that, well, neither Fontaine nor Ryan were that friendly of a guy. So let's see, we got another present from the Little Sisters. So let's open that
it's
up.
It's too dangerous to re-engineer your plasmids in the state Fontaine has put you in. You'll just have to make do with what you have.
So Tenenbaum indicating that we can't use a Gatherer's Garden right now because of our affliction at the moment. But we can, of course, open the gift. So 200 Atom, Armored Shell 2, which is really, really handy, and 12 Incendiary Bolts. So, Armored Shell 2, when the bullets and blows are blasting away, you need all the protection you can get. Armored Shell 2 provides more protection than our competitor. So, let's replace normal Armored Shell with Armored Shell 2. And I must say, Armored Shell 2, I think, gives you 25% damage reduction. Armored Shell 1 gives you 10, and you can actually stack those. But, Atlas lives, we know that already, but let's take a listen.
I grabbed one of the gorillas at the gate to let me in. It's awful in here. To my right, I can see a dead woman lying in the street. Everybody just walking by her like she isn't there. But I noticed something spray painted everywhere. Atlas lives. I mean, I don't know what it means, but something tells me it's important to these people.
So Diane McClintock is, in my mind, one of the more interesting characters in these audio diaries, because she starts off as a defender of Andrew Ryan, a lover even, and she's now starting to turn towards Atlas Fontaine, the one that actually caused her to get maimed in the first place. Not that she knows that, but it's a really cool bit of character development just by audio fragments. So let's hack the U invent here. I think I have... yeah, a few auto hacks left. So let's check this out. So no new things, no new tonics. So I'm gonna just create another automatic hack tool just to fill that up again. Yeah, armor piercing rounds, maybe. I could, I have plenty of stuff left. Then of course, electric gel. Let's take a few of that. One trap bolt. And maybe, more armor piercing rounds? I mean, come on, who cares? Now stuff is dropping out because I made too much, but hey, never mind. We have a lot of crafting materials, so we don't really care now, do we? So let's search this. Hestia chain. Okay, so there's a turret over there, which is really annoying because I can't take it out with... I have enrage at the moment, so... Oh, maybe I get Electro Bolt now? That would be very handy. No, incinerate. Okay. So let's just go over here and get shot at. Because we need to go to the Artemis Suites right over here. So I took care... For some reason, this guy is really tough. He's on fire, but he doesn't care. So let's switch to the pistol. There we go. I'm gonna have some use for those armor-piercing pistol rounds after all, it seems. Gonna have to take out everything like that. Yeah, switch to something else. Hypnotize Big Daddy, why not? Armor-piercing rounds. Oh, stood in the fire there. Shouldn't be standing in the fire. At this point, I'm so strong that I don't really need the camera, so let's just do that. I don't think there actually is much in there either. Whoa. Let's take these guys out with gunfire. Hello. Yeah, die. Thank you. So as you can see, even on this difficulty, I can easily... okay, she looks bad. Can easily take out guys while standing in their line of fire. Don't need that much strategy to do that. Anything in here doesn't look like it. More armor-piercing rounds, though. Which might be handy to take those guys out. Wait, seriously? Where the hell did he go? Jesus Christ. These guys are tough. Those leadhead spices are really, really getting tough. But hey, Artemis Suites. We're where we need to be. But now let's go find Su Chong's lab. As you can see, it kind of looks like the Mercury Suites before. But of course, the Artemis Suites are the lower grade version. So smaller apartments for less than wealthy people. There we go. Let's take that out. Swap out to this. I think there's a lot of splices higher up. Yeah, there we go. There we go. I think I could have got a dud in the face there. So thank Christ for that. Check out the camera. Nothing there. Shotgun with normal bullets probably. And we can see a lot through the windows here. Oh, and I can actually enter, but I'm first gonna go upstairs towards the lab, although the arrow is a kind of... Oh, hi! You know what? Fuck this. There we go. Goodbye. So let's go upstairs and find Su Chong's lab first. Seems like there's a corpse on the next floor, but the shadow is coming through here. It's a bit weird. Room for rent, and a very weird noise coming from this room for rent. But Dr. Su Chong, free clinic. Okay, security bullseye. Oh yeah, there's a camera over there. I didn't think so. I thought that light was that. So let's do that, and now there we go. Can't really use telekinesis right now to take care of the trap bolts. This door seems to be locked. Oh, whoa, fuck. Jesus Christ. So kind of took a turret to the face there. Didn't expect that guy. I think the sound was also completely gone right there. So kind of a bug. Wait, what was that? Gene bank probably. Okay. Let's search this guy. Winter Blast can get through here. Oh yeah, and this is a really, really interesting one. I think you guys are gonna like this one. So, dead splicers. Nothing really new. A lot of blood. This guy seems to be murdered. And I... Okay. Nope, you won't. Bye-bye. Maybe that's actually a pretty easy way to take those guys out, those leadhead splices. Medical expert tree, that's not what I wanted to show you guys, but it might be at the other side of the lab what I wanted to show you. Medical expert tree is gonna go instead of medical expert 2, of course. There we go. Let's see, there's a lot of blood here, but not actually the area I was looking for. So it's gonna be the other side of this place, probably. Target dummy, don't really need that. So let's check out the other side of this place, where we actually need to go, so the lab proper probably. Suchong. Hello, oh yeah, this is what I was looking for. Look at this, the body of a scientist with the drill of a bouncer jammed into its body. So as we search it, just $10, but this, ladies and gentlemen, is Dr. Suchong himself, murdered by a big daddy. And he actually recorded his murder, so let's listen to this.
Clinical trial protector system, Plasmid Roulette 255. Dr. Suchong, client Orion Industries. Very frustrating day. I can't seem to get the damn big daddies to imprint on the little brats. The protection bond is just not forming.
Papa Suchong?
Get away. Maybe if I modify the genetic sequence to... sequence to allow for... Get away, you filthy little shit! What? What are you doing? Get it back! Get back! Stop!
Actually, one of the longer audio diaries, but we can hear Suchong trying to find a way to bind the big daddies to the little sisters, something that he couldn't really achieve until he slapped one of the little sisters in the face, and the big daddy that was close by for testing didn't really like that, as you can see, because he murdered Suchong for it. Actually lost his drill in the process, because that's a really, really gruesome scene. So Dr. Suchong is dead, really, really dead. So let's see if we can't find lot 192 to fix ourselves. Here we go. And there we go, fixed up really, really nicely.
Now you are having freedom. Suchong's drugs should have no hold on you. Check the bathysphere to Point Prometheus. It is time for this matter to be settled.
And that's actually it for Tannenbaum, so now that we're cured, we can actually leave this place, head to Point Prometheus, and try to end Fontaine's life. But we're not really done here yet, because of course I haven't checked out the rest of the apartments here in this building. And then of course we have another interesting building that we haven't checked out before. I think this guy doesn't know where we are. But I can, of course, just take out his head. There we go. I think he got distracted by the bolt flying past his face. Let's see if there's another one. I think she's outside. Yeah, there, her bolt is over there. So let's go over here, gather the bolts, and let's see. Something is firing at me. Don't know what it is, though. I think we're still in stealth. Oh, shit. And that takes care of the bolt as well. So, okay. There we go, let's hack it, and then he should take care of the splicer over there. Or not. Where are you going? Na 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 na. Where did you go? There we go. for me. And now there's another floor, I think. Yeah, so let's go up here first. I don't think we can reach any higher. Although it seems to go higher. But we can't actually reach it over there. So there's another turret. And it's actually a rocket turret. No one touches you? I just did. Okay, that was a miss. Sorry. Oh, for fuck's sake. Never mind. Die already. Okay. So we're inside another apartment, accidentally. Let's check this out first. I don't think there's much here. Except from this dead guy with some bandages. Yeah, okay. So it's only this apartment. Hello, turret. Someone's shooting at me. Yeah, okay. I don't care. I really don't care. I'm just gonna hit you in the face multiple times. So, this apartment. As you can see, these apartments are not just for one person. These are really the poor guy's apartment with a lot of beds, a lot of people living together in the same tiny, well, not tiny apartment, but for a lot of people, it might be just too small. That was a stealth hit, the first one. That's why he took that much damage. A lot of food. Don't really need the frag grenades. Any little sisters down here? Apparently not. So this is the boring side of the apartment, it seems. Let's see if there's anything of interest on the other side here, because it looks like we have some sort of photography room here in the back. Let's check out these steamer trunks. No, nothing. Yeah, looks like we have some pictures and a lot of film, of course. So let's take a few of these. Enzyme, can always use that. And of course a lot of cameras. Can we see something on these pictures, actually? Looks like he's always taking a picture of that seashell for some reason. Don't really know what that is all about. There's a safe here. Let's whack this thing for a second and hack the safe. There we go. And let's see what's inside of this thing. A lot of dollars, proximity mines, and first aid kits. So nothing that we can actually use right now. Let's go back outside. I think there's another apartment downstairs that we haven't checked out yet. And yeah, this place is also filled with lots of horrible noises for some reason. I'm wondering, I don't think we can get anything here because I think we checked out everything. Yeah. So let's check the first floor and we might actually find something here. Some things that we missed because we kind of blazed through this area. We don't need to go over there just yet. We have a lot of money. So might as well check out the inventory. I know, I kind of did already. Oh, that was a different vending machine, right? So I didn't really check out the inventory of that one, but I might start checking the inventory before hacking because that was kind of a waste. Let's see. So more apartments where a lot of people apparently live together. Jesus loves me, this unknown. Oh, another turret. No, let's hack it. Hi. Oh, that's a dud. And there we go. Took care of that. Grenade launcher, more proximity mines. Yeah, nothing we can actually use. Feels like something is firing at something. Like a lot. Don't know where it's coming from. There's a corpse just around here as well. I do remember there being a lot of hidden little items in between these mattresses and stuff, but I'm just gonna kind of blaze through. It's not the most interesting of areas, and but I don't want to miss anything, right? Just for your guys' sake, because yeah, I don't think there's much of interest here. We could hack this other UN vent, but yeah, I don't really see the point. So there's a lot of gunfire outside this place. Hello? Yep, okay. Well, if you're having fun up there, I'm just gonna leave. Okay? Yeah, okay, thank you. So now I'm gonna head to the other side of this area. We haven't yet taken care of any of the big daddies, so we're gonna have to do that first. Goodbye, that was a nice somersault. I'm gonna have to take care of two big daddies. in this area, which we haven't done yet. But there's also another really, really cool area in this place. A really cool building. Let's see. I think he's still alive. No. Goodbye. I'm wondering, do you have a little sister with you already? Might as well take out. Doesn't seem like he has a little sister with him. Hi! Oh. This guy takes a lot of hits. What are you doing? He was just standing there. The hell was that? I think there's another female one close by. There we go. Healed up to full again. Yeah, get your little sister ready and I'll get my traps ready. Let's start off with proximity mines. Put these on one of the barrels over here. Yeah, nice. Right. Would be really, really nice. And then I might actually use a bit of the trap bolts. Oh, there's another turret here. Forgot about that guy. There we go. I could use the trap bolts, but it's a bit of an open area. Way too big of an open area for that. So let's just use telekinesis. Grab our little trap thingy here.
Hurry,
get a bit of distance between us. And there we go. Because we researched them pretty, pretty well good. And we can kill them easily right now. So let's rescue her. Giving us a bit more Adam. Thank you, little sister. Schwa.
Thank
you. Goodbye. You're welcome.
Thank
Glad
you.
I could help. So now we can actually check out the Gatherer's Guard now that we fixed ourselves. Let's see what else we have here. Nothing really of interest. So I'm just going to buy out all the slots we're still missing. So there we go. Physical tonic slot. Let's see. You know what? Let's just go for Eve Link for now. Then we have the engineering tonics. There we go. Reduce difficulty when hacking turrets, bolts, and cameras. No. Inventing. No. Greatly reduces difficulty when hacking turrets, bolts, and no. Flow speed. Yeah, that's a good one. Oh, I can't buy another slot here. That's weird. Why can't I buy another slot? Well, let's buy another plasmid slot then. Let's see. I think I'm going to go for... we don't really have that much, actually. Well, let's go for target dummy for now then. Yeah, we saw that. And let's keep the rest in our inventory for now. Because we're going to get a lot more in a minute. Because, of course, that's not the only big daddy we need to take out. But we're going to go in this direction next. Because there's something really interesting at the end of this street here, I think. Or am I going the wrong way? Let's see. So this is the way back. I still want to go... I think we missed one little sister over at Olympus Heights. So we're gonna have to go there as well. You know what? I'm gonna take a little break. When we get back, we're first gonna go back to Olympus Heights. Kill one big daddy to get the little sister over there. Because I don't think we killed that second one already.
Blood! The blood!
Yeah, the blood is the blood. Are you seriously gonna heal right now? And after that, we'll head towards Prometheus Point. But first, thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!